It is time once again for the Real People Multi-Game Style Tournament. We are about to get into Raging Champions here. It's the sports leg of the English / Pasha Roo leg, the sports shunt off the English Posh / Pasha - Roo leg. And this is number two. We did number one a couple months ago. It's been a while. I think it was last year, maybe. With Power Play, and in Power Play, if you recall, Little Red won that. He is going to be the ultimate like champion finalist that our other raging champions are going to have to compete with each other in order to have the opportunity to battle against in Raging Champions. Now, I went through a lot of phases, like I often do, with this game, in terms of how I was actually going to do it. At first, I was going to have the Raging, kind of this like kind of dual level thing where there was Raging Champions happening, but the actual battles were going to be taking place in another series that I did a while back called These Hanging Strings. Then I was going to, my table now has been full of this Days of Decision game for a long time, and that's doesn't seem to be going away anytime soon, and I would need a little more table space for that, so and time is also a problem, as evidenced by the fact that we're just now getting to Raging Champions. It's not like it's that hard of a game to play, folks, and I'll tell you about that in a moment. But then I was going to have each of the Raging Champions have a different power, because they are all basically the same, despite being chock full of character. They all play the same. But then I said, no, you are going to get unadulterated, pure, uncut, Raging Champions pumping through your veins here now. So I'm going to turn the camera to the game, and we're going to see what it's like to be Raging Champions. This is our Raging Champions board here. You see that it's set up like a tournament, and that's because Raging Champions is a raging battle tournament where you're gonna have these awesome fighters and they're gonna battle each other. Basically, you're a coach for your awesome fighters, and you're gonna have to go through either the Mountain Conference or the Island Conference in order to become the conference champion and then get into the finals. Now, one change I did make to the game is that after you're the tournament champion, your game doesn't end there, because you're gonna have to take on Little Red with his Opportunity Knocks card to see who can be the ultimate raging champion and get to move the most spaces in the sports track of careers. So since you can't find Raging Champions new anymore, I don't think. I got my copy used. That means that this character here, Tornado, was not in my copy, because the person who had it before really grew attached to Tornado. So I think Tornado maybe won their tournament, and so they got rid of all the other people, kept Tornado. So I'm using these three bunnies for Tornado, and they're going to be on the team with Chubbs right here. All right, so let's take a look at our teams here. Each player has a team of two. If you play with fewer players, we're playing an eight-player game of Raging Champions. If you play with fewer players, you're just going to divide the 16 total characters among the people you have, and then remainders are just going to be kind of played on their own, which is fine. You could probably play Raging Champions by yourself. It wouldn't really matter. You have two choices in the game. Your first choice is where your Raging Champion. Well, first you get to pick your Raging Champions, but mechanically that doesn't really do anything. But you get to pick where your Raging Champion starts in the tournament, and then you also have these two appeal chips, which let you re-roll a die. You get two that you use during the game. And those are the main two choices you're going to make. So let's look at our teams here. Stubby here, he has Lumber Louie. Lumber Louie has really strong hands, and he has Midnight. Midnight is pure evil. And when they start their battles, I'll tell you a little bit more about them, because these characters, there's a lot to them. One of the highlights of the game is these character blurbs, where you get to learn about these awesome champions. And so here we have Crudball. Crudball's big, and kind of like Midnight, he's a bad guy. He's not afraid to cheat. And then you have Mo. Mo is kind of spectacular in that he has no superpowers. He was the last person to make it into the tournament. So
there's Mo. So he's kind of an underdog. Then over here we have Chubbs. One thing I remember about Chubbs is that when Chubbs gets angry, he's really powerful. And then you have Tornado. Tornado, he looks like this normally when he's not in bunny form. But Tornado, he's really good in the early rounds. Then we have Twinkles and Sassy. They're both girls. And then we have Clambake. Clambake was the former champion. He's got hands as strong as Lumber Louie from Shucking Clams. And then Mambo Ant. Mambo Ant, if he's focused, he's unstoppable. We have Princess. This is Kaz and Kat's team. Princess and the Majesty. She kind of went with a royalty theme for her team. Majesty, he's got legs of concrete and arms of iron. And the Princess, she had some great teachers. And then we have Stem and Wiggleworm. They like to hang out together. Stem has like hypnotic bloodshot eyes. These are juniors people. And Wiggleworm, he can wiggle around. Giggle Guts, Monkey Shine, natural partners. Probably fortunate for Monkey Shine since Giggle Guts is like the only person who can withstand Monkey Shine's pranks. So let's get started. I have got to distribute them. I'm probably going to distribute them based on whether I think they're from an island or from a mountain. And try not to have people of the same team matched up against each other. And then kind of go from there. And as you can see, our champions, they are ready to rage. I hope I can remember who is who. I think the rules say that we start up here and then we move down. And then we go up here and we move down. And then we see how things go. So first we have Lumber Louie, who is... That's Stubbies versus Sassy, who is Smiley's. Okay, so here's how it works. Each player is going to get a D12 and then a raging die. And I think one's called a tournament die and one's the raging die. I don't remember which is which. And they're going to roll them. So this will be, and I think this is supposed to have stickers all on it, but it looks like it's missing some. So what we'll say is the white ones don't do anything. Or maybe that's how it's supposed to be. This one looks like it has three stickers too. Okay. So if you roll a color, you get to roll that. You get to draw that card, and that's going to have some effect. Usually it's going to change your roll somehow. Here's Lumber Louie's roll. He's got a four green. Green's life cards. Life cards are the best, I think, overall. All right, and then what's Sassy going to do? Oh, nine, but no card. Okay, so let's see what card Lumber Louie got here. He got a plus six, so that was just enough. And that's one of the higher things here. Lumber Louie, so she could decide to appeal right now, but I think she's going to save her appeal for later. I don't know. I think she's kind of attached to Sassy. That plus six is hard, though. I don't think she's going to be able to get a better roll than that. So Sassy's out of the tournament right now. Lumber Louie moves up to the semifinals. Now we have the Majesty, who is Kaz and Kat's, versus Giggle Guts, which is one of Teacher Flush's. Oh, I should tell you about Sassy since she's leaving the tournament. Sassy, an abrasive girl who learned everything from school, the School of Hard Knocks. She has seen it all and ready for combat. Always a contender. Lumber Louie, as you know, he has powerful hands that are hard to escape from. This guy loves competition. He's also a lumberjack who started sawing wood at age four. Now we have the Majesty with arms of steel and legs of cement. This player is tough to beat. Before this tournament, he has never lost. The Majesty is a tournament favorite to win. He's going against Giggle Guts. Giggle Guts, you may think, looks absurd. But check this out. The fans love this character. Non-stop giggling, that's contagious, even to its opponents. One of the few players in the tournament that Monkey Shine can't irritate. Surprisingly good. All right, so we're going to put this back under here. I'm not sure if I should reshuffle that or not. Hold on. The rules don't say, so I decided to just make a discard pile. And the discard pile's all filled up, like there's nothing to draw from. You shuffle up the discard pile, put it back up into the deck, and rage. Okay, so here we go. Majesty is going to roll first. Normally you could do this simultaneously, but since the dice are all the same color, I wouldn't know whose is whose. Majesty got nine blank. Flush rolling on behalf of Giggle Guts. He got eight purple. Oh my gosh. So this purple is a doctor card. Some of these are negative. Some of the life cards are negative too. It's just fewer of them are. So this could really make or break it for Flush here. Doctor says take a hot tub. Plus two to your score. That's going to be just enough for Giggle Guts to take the Majesty out unless the Majesty or the Majesty's coach wants to appeal the decision with this appeal chip. Does she want to? Does she want to lose the Majesty? She doesn't care about the Majesty. She wants the princess to win. So Giggle Guts is going to go in. Looks like it's going to be Giggle Guts versus Lumber Louie in the semi-finals here. Next up is going to be Stem, who's got those hypnotic bloodshot eyes. If you recall, Stem, a skinny, wiry man that is hard to pin down. His bloodshot eyes put a spell on his opponents that is hard to resist. Likes to hang out with his bro, Mambo Ant. Okay, Stem's going against Midnight. Ooh, this is kind of scary. The dark side contender is evil. The massiveness of Midnight is only offset by his unwillingness to play by the rules. Midnight frequently gets ejected from tournaments. Could be unstoppable. We'll see. Is Midnight unstoppable? The Majesty, this is his first loss ever. Okay, so this is going to be a tournament of upsets. Stem's going to try to use his bloodshot eyes on Midnight. Six with a doctor card. Okay, does the doctor have what Stem is ordering? Or is Midnight going to break the rules in just the right way? Two. Ooh. Let's see what the doctor says. Plus six. 12. Oh my gosh. Stem just dominated Midnight. Midnight's out of the tournament. I don't think a reroll is going to be able to. I mean, that's a 12. That's pretty tough. So Stem's going to go into the semifinals. Now we're going to go Twinkles. That's Smiley against Snugbug's Mo. Did Snugbug have Midnight, or who had Midnight? I need to. Did I write that down? I should have wrote that down. Who had Midnight? It was either Snugbug or. This is going to matter now because if. I think. No, Mo was with Crudball. So. Midnight was. Whose? Was he Stubby's? I gotta go look back at the first scene because I or the scene where I had him lined up. Sorry, I didn't mean to deflate the momentum here. We're gonna go right back after this message is the Raging Champions. All right, we figured it out. Stubby was Midnight's coach. Okay, and Stubby's doing fine. He's got Lumber Louie here in the semi-semifinals. So now it's going to be Mo. Nothing special about Mo going against Twinkles. Let's take a look at what we know about them. Mo, the last qualifier to enter the tournament. No super strength or skills, but he qualified. Long shot to win. Twinkles, a humble girl that sparkles. She finds a way to win. Her unassuming personality allows her to take opponents by surprise. This player is a sleeper that could go all the way. So we got some kind of similarities between these two competitors here. Twinkles is kind of the unassuming kind of underdog who comes back to win. Mo is kind of the same way, right? And how he's described, except Mo is not expected to win, whereas Twinkles kind of is. I think Twinkles maybe has some star power, a little more glitz, a little more glam going on, but maybe Mo is this true sleeper. There's only one way to find out, and that is to rage! Let's go. All right, Twinkles is first. Seven green, that is a strong roll for Twinkles. Mo, and remember, Stubby doesn't care too much if Twinkles does well. Smiley's going to be all in for Twinkles here since her sassy is already eliminated from the Raging Champions Tournament. Ooh, eight black. Okay. Black is referee card. We haven't seen any of these yet. It's going to be interesting to see what happens here. Mo, we haven't... Not having superpowers, you could see how he might do something illegal. So, we'll see. Let's get the life card first for Twinkles. Five to her score. That's 12. That's going to be really hard for Mo to beat. Minus three. He showed up late. Mo, if you're going to be the worst competitor, at least show up on time. Okay, let one of these prima donnas pull one of those things. On the other hand, Joe, maybe Mo has a job. Maybe he has kids that he had to drop off at school, or maybe he had to take him to a doctor's appointment. You don't know what he's going through. Don't judge. Okay, you're right. So Mo is out of the game. He's going to go back here with Weasel, I think. Is he Weasel or Snugbug? Yeah, he's with Snugbug. Okay, and Twinkles moves on. That's really good for Smiley. She does not want to have to use her appeal chips this early on. And if Twinkles hadn't taken that one, she would have been out of the tournament. All right, let's move on to the Island Conference. Let's get a little tropical here with Clambake versus the Princess. Clambake, if you remember, is the current champion of Raging Champions. Let's see, put these in the right spot. There we go. Okay, and what else do we know about Clambake? He was shucking clams. I was telling you that from memory. Let's take a look at the sheet here. Hold on while I open this up. Got a little stuck together, I'm sorry. At last year's tournament champion, he is sure to win some matches. This huge, powerful guy, his hands as strong as Lumber Louie from shucking clams most of his life and carrying hot boiling kettles of water up and down the beach. This player should be a first pick. And you can see that. Look at that. That's your first pick, isn't it? You love Clambake. But let's take a look at Princess. She's not too shabby herself. Remember, the Majesty is out of this, so Kaz and Kat's going to be going all in on Princess here. Princess, Her Highness has been to the best schools for study and martial arts. She's very smart and stronger than she looks. With the world's best teachers, she rarely loses. Okay, so we're doing a champion against someone who rarely loses. But can her desperation to be the best, can her coaches, best teacher there. Look at how good of a teacher Kaz. She's holding her baby. She's teaching her baby how to be a great coach. All right. Clambake. Clambake 3 white. That is sad, former champion. And here we have 10 white. That's pretty nice. Okay, so I got to look at the appeal chip rules to see if we get to roll both dice. What's this dude's name? Yeah, Danimal. If Danimal gets to roll both dice or just one die, let's take a look here. Danimal doesn't want his Clambake to lose, so he's going to use one of his appeal chips right now. That's going to cause both players to roll again. We're going to do Clambake again. So it's like the whole match is redone. He's like, hey, there was something untoward happened there. 11 purple. Wow. That's a comeback for the champion here. Now remember, Cash, she does not want Princess to lose, so she is going to probably appeal this if she doesn't win. 2 white. All right, let's see what the purple does first. You broke your finger. That's going to take it down to 7. That's still not enough. So we're going to see another appeal. This first match here on the island tournament is exciting. We're going for a third round of fighting between Clambake and the Princess. Neither one is willing to back down. 2 white. Princess gets 5 white. That's going to be just enough. Does Danimal want to appeal? He's still got his Mambo. Does he have Mambo Ant? Or who's his other guy? Mambo Ant's with Sten. Does he have Wiggle Worm? I think he has Wiggle Worm, maybe. I don't remember who his other guy is. Okay, hold on. I got to find that out. I'll be right back. That's why I was confused. I messed it up. So Mambo Ant should have been with... on Stem's team with Junior. And Wiggle Worm should have been on Clambake's team. The reason why, so I had remembered that Mambo Ant was friends with somebody, or that Stem was friends with somebody. I remember that Stem was friends with somebody. I thought it was Wiggle Worm, but it's actually Mambo Ant. So I want those two to be on the same team. So I just swapped it around. It's going to be okay. So Danimal's team is now Wiggle Worm and Clambake. And Junior's team is Mambo Ant and Stem. Okay, so I think Danimal's going to... He likes Clambake a lot better than Wiggle Worm. I think he's going to appeal it. It's an appeal! All right, fourth round between Clambake and Princess here. 7 white, that's not what you want to see when you're out of appeal chips in the very start of the game, and she's got 11 purple. Unless this doctor's card is calamitous, this is going to be the game. That's a -3. That takes her down to 8. That's still enough. Clambake is out. The champion's out in the first round. Princess is going forward. Wow. Kaz and Kat has got to be excited right now. Her princess has just taken out last year's champion, and she's moving on to the semifinals. All right, now we got the battle of the big guys. Chubbs versus Crudball. Now, Chubbs, he's normally a good-natured, heavy-set player. When this competitor gets mad, he has an attitude like no other. His weight and temper could carry him far. On a good day, Chubbs can go to the finals. A Crudball, on the other hand, is kind of like Chubbs' opposite, or Chubbs' negative, a dirty player who will lie, cheat, and steal. Although he is big and strong, he usually wins through intimidation. The player is not popular with the fans, but can easily be a champion, a raging champion, gentlemen and ladies. Chubbs goes first. This is Weasel's Chubbs, and Crudball is Snugbugs. 7 black for Chubbs. That's a pretty good roll. Black is referee, though. A lot of those are negative. White, 11. So a lot's going to matter on this. Minus 7. You were caught cheating. Chubbs is going to be out of it unless Weasel wants to appeal. I think Weasel is pretty disappointed in Chubbs, and he's not going to appeal that. He thinks Chubbs deserves to be out of the Raging Championship because he was cheating. Though I wonder if maybe Crudball didn't make it look like he was cheating. That seems like a Crudball move. So we see two referee cards. They're both negative so far. All right, now we got, this is going to be a fun one, okay? Because we got Monkey Shine versus Mambo Ant. You ready for this? Monkey Shine's got a lot of tricks, and Mambo Ant, he's real laid back, likes to play it cool. But if he gets focused, you just watch out. One white for Monkey Shine. I think Mambo Ant's feeling pretty focused right now. All right, what do we got? Four white. Okay, so that's going to be enough for Mambo Ant. Does Monkey Shine want to appeal? So let's see. Monkey Shine is flushes. His other guy is Giggle Guts, who's still in the tournament. I think flush would allocate one to each. So he's going to do another one. Let's learn a little bit about Monkey Shine while our competitors get ready for their next round. Monkey Shine, always playing around, likes to play tricks and pranks on everyone. A very clever monkey whose cleverness sometimes backfires. Be careful of this one. The monkey is tricky. Now Mambo Ant, an island ant that is street smart. This muscle-bound insect is laid back, but has bursts of strength that nothing can match. When Mambo is focused, he is unbeatable. So let's see how focused Mambo is. First, Flush needs to cash in his appeal chip there. All right, he's given Monkey Shine another lease on life. Let's see if Monkey Shine's got a trick up his furry sleeve. Four purple, that could mean he has a trick, a doctor trick. Let's see what Mambo Ant has going for him. Six black. Ooh, okay. First, let's see what the doctor trick is. Plus four. No broken bones. Plus four for having no broken bones. So he's got eight. Right now, Monkey Shine is winning it. Mambo Ant gets a plus three for nine. Flush is not going to appeal that. He wanted to divvy them up evenly. Giggle Guts has this other appeal chip. Monkey Shine is already out of the tournament. I'm a little disappointed. I would have been disappointed no matter what. Both of these competitors are a lot of fun to watch. It's great to see competitors that aren't human compete Raging Championship. And they both have great personalities that are a joy. Now, here we go. We have to move on. We have Tornado versus Wiggle Worm. Now, this is an interesting matchup. Tornado is by far the favorite to win because it's an early matchup. According to my dossier here, unprecedented speed and twisting power will be a star on any team, unlikely to lose in the early in the tournament. So he's unlikely to lose right now because this is early in the tournament for him. Should be a top pick by a coach to lead their team. Compare that to Wiggle Worm here. Can't sit still. Always moving. So this is going to be a very kinetic matchup. We're going to have a lot of motion here. A tough competitor against Stem. This battler can really wiggle. Should upset some stronger players. So, what can we glean from that? It could go either way, people. This is going to be exciting. We have Tornado here. Let's see what he rolls. What's that? Crudball, get out of the way. It's a 12 purple. What? Oh my gosh. They weren't kidding. He's tough to beat early on, but Wiggle Worm isn't done wiggling yet. Five white. Oh, man. Okay, let's see what the doctor card says. 15. 15. That's huge. Wiggle Worm. Wiggle Worm. Who's Wiggle Worm's partner? His partner was, oh, his partner was Clambake. And you have no appeals left, do you? He is out. And Danimal is out. He has got last place in the tournament. That was sad, Danimal. Sad, Wiggle Worm. I mean, it wasn't sad. Sorry, I'm trying to be mean. I was just kind of being mean. Sorry about that. Okay, now we're going to go on to the semifinals. It's going to be Lumber Louie against Giggle Guts. Lumber Louie fighting for Stubby. Giggle Guts, as you recall, is Flush's man. I've already seen some laughter and will the joy of humor continue, or will it fall to the rage? 11 black for Lumber Louie. Wow, he does have strong hands. Giggle Guts? Giggle Guts might surprise him, though. Takes a lot to bother Giggle Guts. That's 8. Let's see what the referee card is first. You are kicked out of the tournament. See ya! Oh, man. I knew that card was in there. Lumber Louie was the one who drew it. And I don't know that you can appeal that. A kicked out of the tournament. I mean, can you? Can you appeal that? I guess so. It doesn't say anything about that. And it does say you get to re-roll if you do an appeal chip. You just kind of redo the match. So I think he appealed the kicking out. That's kind of what an appeal would do, right? Okay. Lumber Louie going again against Giggle Guts. 11 white. Another strong roll. And I think he probably doesn't want to be drawing any cards after what that last one got him. Kicked out of the tournament. 2 purple. So unless this purple one is awesome, Giggle Guts is going to have to appeal. Sprained your ankle, got a 0. You don't want that. Okay, this is going to be Flush's final appeal chip. Lumber Louie's going again. 8 white. Respectable. Respectable. Not dominating, but respectable. You can see how much these competitors really want to win the championship by how they're using their appeal chips to re-roll. All right, we got purple Mambo Ant. 5 purple. Okay, so a lot is going to matter on this one card. -4, Giggle Guts. Your toe is broken. People are going to be talking about this for a long time. Lumber Louie won, okay? But people are going to be talking about, they're going to be saying, remember when it said see ya? Maybe that meant he should have been gone. Maybe that's what that meant. But instead, the ref decided to allow him to appeal after he got a see ya? Whatever. Hopefully these two can laugh it off because they're out of the tournament, and so are you, Flush. Sorry, buddy. All right. Stem with his hypnotic eyes going up against Twinkles. Twinkles, another desperation candidate. Stem is also not desperate. Junior's got a player on each side, so Smiley has a lot more to lose. Here he goes. Hypnotic eyes, bloodshot eyes, 7 white. All right, that's okay. Not the worst. Twinkles. Show him what you got. 12 white. Does Junior want to throw one in? He's going to appeal that. Does he want to? Does he want to just stick with Mambo Ant? Who is he going up against with Mambo Ant? Junior's going to think about this. He's wanting to think about this. Mambo Ant. So he would be going against Tornado, who has 2 appeal chips already. I think he's going to keep his appeal chips for that matchup. And let... Yeah, and let Stem drop out of this one. Twinkles wins. Stem is out of the tournament. All right, we're going to go up top here. Princess versus Crudball. Ooh. What's it got to be like to be brought up in this pristine environment, have everyone cater to you, and then have to interact so closely with such a disgusting human being as the Crudball? Ooh, pretty tough to deal with, but maybe it's a valuable life lesson. All right, here we go. Crudball retaliates with a 12. Can the princess pull anything out? -2. She got a 1. That's really hard on her. Well, Kaz, no other choice but to use her final appeal to see if she can get through this. -2 from her score. That's harsh. All right, here we go. Rolling again. Crudball, get out of the way. 7 blank. And Crudball is going to roll... 2 purple. Unfortunately, I have to reshuffle the purple. We'll take a look at little red while I do that. This is looking very good for Princess, though. He would have to get a +5 to tie it, in which case they reroll, or a +6 to win it. If he gets a +6, Kaz and Kat has no more appeals, so that would make the tournament over for her. Recall, she already lost the Majesty. The Majesty already lost. Surprisingly. Okay, let's see what our doctor draw is here for Crudball. +6! He got a +6! Okay, Princess is out of it. Dang. And how... Oh, because his broken arm healed. So I think he was fighting with a broken arm, and then it got better just in time to beat the Princess. Man. Okay, so Tornado had an early lead there. Had a fast beginning to the tournament, getting that fast victory against Wiggleworm. But now he's got to go against Mambo Ant, and it's not so early in the tournament anymore. We're down to 5 competitors, so I don't know if he still has that advantage. We'll let Mambo Ant go first. 11 blank. That's going to be tough for Tornado to beat here. 4 blank. Okay, he's going to use an appeal. Chubbs is already out of the tournament. Why not, Weasel, right? You're going for this. Junior is up on appeal chips here. Junior is Mambo Ant's coach. Mambo Ant, if you want to win, okay, we're going to need to see what the roll is. 11 blank again. Wow, Mambo Ant is nothing if not consistent and an ant. Here comes Chubbs, or not Chubbs, Tornado. 9 purple. Let's see what you got now. Not going to be +6, -4. That's rough. You got to use another appeal, though, don't you? I mean, otherwise you're out of the tournament, Weasel. You got to try, okay? I know it looks bad, but when the chips are down and you're down chips, you got to keep trying. Here we go. Mambo Ant, 4 blank. Ooh, looks like he's starting to tire out. And let's see what Tornado has. 9 blank. That's going to be enough to beat him. But guess what? Junior has an appeal chip. So he's going to appeal that right now. And it's going to be, what, round 4 between these two competitors? Mambo Ant, 3 blank. Dang, that's not what you want. 6 black. Now this could actually drop it down, depending. Whoop. +7. Wow! You protected the referee from angry people, so the referee gave him 7 points. Another appeal chip by Junior. Oh my gosh, both competitors had to use all their appeal chips in order to see how this is actually going to turn out. And here we go. Last possible match. Last possible match between, or round, between Mambo Ant and Tornado. And that's round 5 here. You're not going to see this any other place in the tournament. 5 blank. Not what you want to see there, Junior. Versus 2 green. Oh, now, but it's a life card. +5. That's +7. Tornado pulled an upset there. I thought Mambo Ant had it for sure. Tornado's going to the finals against Crudball. Or semifinals, I don't know. Okay, now Lumber Louie versus Twinkles. Now if we look, Stubby's got 1. Twinkles has got 2. I thought for sure she had to appeal before, but maybe not. I don't know what's going on. Okay. Lumber Louie. That's a terrible roll. I think he's too used to lumberjacking with a bunch of guys. Not used to females around. Okay, 6 black, -2, -4. That's still enough. He's going to appeal that. Lumber Louie is in it to win it. That's his last appeal chip, though. Lumber Louie goes. He's got an 11 purple, huge, dominating roll. And 12 purple, what? Okay, so we'll let Lumber Louie draw his first. -3, that's 8, +2. Twinkle Toes takes down Lumber Louie. Or not Twinkles, I think. Yeah, not Twinkle Toes, just Twinkles. Take a hot tub. You won the match, and you are going to be in the finals against whoever wins this one. Crudball versus Tornado. 6 white for Crudball, but he's got 2 appeal chips there. 10 white. That's going to be enough, but Snugbug's going to use an appeal. And Tornado has no more appeal chips left. Snugbug versus Weasel here. Crudball's got a 6 purple. I don't know if he's happy or sad about that purple. We'll see. We got a 10 white. He's hoping for something in that purple then. -4. That's not what you want. Got to use his last appeal chip. Okay, it's down to it. This is exciting. I mean, you wouldn't think this game is just a bunch of dice rolling would be exciting, but I don't know who's going to win right now. I mean, it's down to it. They've used their appeal chips, right? It's just those two. And Twinkles is sitting here with 2 appeal chips. So what's going to happen with that? 4 black. Okay, let's draw his... Well, we'll draw his black next. Crudball. Gotta quit cheating, man. 9 black. Oh, this is looking familiar. Remember when we had to draw those 2 doctor cards and that was like the fate? Now it's the 2 referee cards. Oh, okay. Referee there. +5. That's 9 right there. So they're tied. So all of it's going to depend on what the referee says for Tornado here. No points. No points. Oh. Does that mean So does that mean he just has no points? Or does that mean he adds no points? No point. I think that means we re-roll the whole thing. I don't know. Otherwise, it's the same as the C, isn't it? Yeah, we're going to re-roll the whole thing. This is going to be another point of contention. Oops, sorry, Twinkles. Credball versus Tornado. Just going to roll up. 8 green. That's a nice one for Credball. He's got to be happy about that. And then we have a 9 white. What's this green one going to be? -4. Crudball is out of it. Tornado goes to the championships. That was surprising. If you remember, Crudball went into that with 2 appeal chips. Okay? Weasel had none. And look what he did. Now it's going to be Sparkles against Tornado. Kind of like an elemental final here. And we have 6 black for Sparkle. Not quite what she would like. And then a 10 white. So she's going to have to watch me shuffle the deck. She needs a black card. Remember, there's that no points card in there. And there's that Sia card in there. So I think it might. And plenty of negative cards too. So it'd be safe to predict or to bet if you were betting with your friends at home right now. As you're watching this on YouTube.com. It'd be safe to bet that she's going to have to use an appeal chip. But let's see. She's a much more likable character. +5 to her score. That's going to be it. Sparkles is going to go against a new challenger. Little Red. He's not even a coach. He just goes in there. Let's see what he's got. He's going to go in there and he's going to roll a 7 white. Here's Sparkles. 1 white. She's going to use her appeal chip. 6 green. 5 white. Let's see what his life card is. +3. She has to use another appeal chip. 12 white. Oh my gosh, Little Red is really good at raging. 4 green. +7. That's going to be just enough to be one away from winning. And so Little Red takes it. It's going to be Smiley in second place. Who is next? Was it Crudball? No, it was Tornado. Who had Tornado? Oh, Weasel. And then this guy. And then, I don't know, maybe these two. And then these three. I think he was before these two. Yeah, I think she was too. I'll say, yeah. That'll be our ranking here for what we do with careers. I hope you all enjoyed that, Raging Champions. The game, honestly, was a lot more fun than I expected. It probably helps to talk when you're playing it. Probably you should talk to whoever you're playing the game with. It's not a game you play quietly. It's a game you need to rage, and that's how you become a champion. Thanks.